It's now time for a quick tip. In this tip, I'm going to show you how you can access the value of a JavaScript property in your CSS file in Lightning Web Components. Take this use case. You've built a reusable component and you want the styles of that component like background color or text color to be configured by an admin using the app builder. Here, I'm assigning black as the background color and white as the text color. So how would you do this? First, of course, you would create two JavaScript properties and decorate them with the API decorator, and then use the meta file to expose these properties to the app builder. In order to style your component based on these values, you would use JavaScript to query for the element and then apply the style using .style.styleName and assign the JavaScript property value to that. While this works, it is not the most elegant way to do this. First, this is slower. And second, in case you have more elements in the future that you want to apply the style to, you would simply have to query all of those elements using the query selector, which again makes it further slower. The answer to this is to use CSS custom properties. They are nothing but variables in your CSS file. All you need to do is declare these variables in your CSS file. Here, I've declared two properties, one for the background color and one for text color. And in all of my CSS classes, I'm using the value of these CSS custom properties. The syntax is var, and in brackets, you put the name of the CSS custom property. Now, how do I assign the JavaScript properties value to the CSS custom property? You would actually do it using the same JavaScript syntax, but instead of selecting every individual element, you're going to just select the place where you've declared the property. Here it is the host. So you would say template.host.style, and you would use the set property method, and you would pass the property name and property value. You can use the same concept to style base components. To style base components, we have exposed styling hooks, which are nothing but CSS custom properties. So in case you want to change the color of, in this example, it's a badge. If you want to change the background color of the badge, you would find the relevant styling hook and then use the same set property syntax in order to set the value of the styling hook to that color. And that is how you style your components based on JavaScript property values. Hope this tip was useful.
Hello again, and it's tip time. Today, I'll show you how to enable and disable the debug mode right from your Visual Studio Code. You can use tools like Chrome Developer Tools to debug your components during development. But one important point to keep in mind is this has a significant performance impact. So it is necessary that you enable the debug mode only when it is required. Again, changing the debug mode from the org setup frequently is little annoying. So let's see how we can do that from the Visual Studio Code. Here we are in a project where I have written an anonymous apex script within the script/apex folder. Here we are getting the current user and updating user preferences user debug mode ref to true. Let's run this code and see what happens. Let's now open the default org. And here you can see that the debug mode is enabled. And also, if you see the debug mode in the settings, the checkbox is checked for the current user. Let's now go back to VS Code and disable the debug mode by setting this value to false. Let's run this once again and check how it worked. It looks like the debug mode is disabled. Let's check in the settings. Here you can see that the debug mode is disabled. there are various other user preferences that you can set. To learn more about it, you can check the user object documentation in the object reference for Salesforce and Lightning platform. Not just that, you can also set the development mode for the Visual Force pages using the user preferences Apex pages developer mode. You may check this guide for more such preferences. Let's now see how this works. Let's copy this setting, go back to the VS Code, and paste it here. Let's save it and run the script once again. Now the development mode option must have been enabled. Let's go and check. Here, I'll click my username, click settings, and then advanced user details. Now you can see that the development mode is set to true. We hope this tip was helpful. Please let us know.